She went to the dealer to buy a brand new Toyota pickup truck. Nice truck, V6. The salesman told her he was gonna sell her the truck for $31,000. Now here in the state of Texas, an oral agreement is binding. Somebody tells you something, it was a salesman working at the dealer, that means it's legal. People you don't trust, get out your phone, put it on record, put it in your pocket, wherever. You can record everything that's going on. If they say they didn't say that, you can play it back. Because in her case,
I trusted the salesperson. When I came in, he had one 2019 Toyota Tacoma left, $31,000. I said, we agreed on the $31,000, and he would give me $11,000 for my trade-in.
Sounded like a fair deal. They ended up selling her the car for $46,616.96. With these addendums that were added on.
And I signed the papers. I trusted the salesperson and thought they was being honest with me. And he put everything I signed into an envelope. Honest deal. I didn't think about looking at the papers or going over it. I trusted him. He didn't really go over no prices with me. He just had pointed and told me sign here, and sign there, and initial.
So then you get the bill from Toyota, and what happens?
I'm looking at it, and I was like, oh no, this can't be right. So I called up and asked to speak to them, and they put me on hold. So I just drove down there and waited around till I can talk to somebody that would talk to me. And when I went in there, I asked them about it, and I asked them how they could get this from $31,000 and plus my trade-in, which would be minus $11,000. And they went to doing all this talking about addendums, and I'm still totally confused.
So after they gave her this piece of paper with the stuff they wrote on addendums, which they hadn't given to her before, they hit her with a hefty finance charge. The percentage was way too high. As you can see here, her total payoff was going to be $65,395. She went to her credit union and refinanced it. Here's what happened there. Now, the total payoff is $45,181. Quite a bit of difference. I mean, you gotta take advantage of by the price was raised, he wasn't told, and the finance rates were high. You gotta be wary of these people nowadays. Now, I even have to say there's kind of false advertising inside the door. Because when you look here, what does it say? It says, manufactured Baja California. That's Baja California, Mexico. Wasn't made in California. Average Joe's gonna look at that thing and say, oh, it was made in California. No, it wasn't made in California. Not in the United States at any rate. It was made in Mexico. And I'm sure the salesperson didn't tell him anything about that.
Okay, did they tell you it was made in Mexico?
No, they did not.
No, it is a new truck. There's no arguing that. It wasn't like they sold her some old wrecked thing, but they took advantage. She never had this happen before. She's bought numerous new cars. It's the first time anybody ever pulled something like this on her. Now, I guess you're never too old to learn. Even I'm still learning stuff at 66. So, my advice, when you go to any kind of deal, cars, anything, especially in Texas, record the whole thing. Then if they say something and they try to renege on it, they can. Now, of course, you got to read the contracts. And if you're not a contract person, bring a contract person with you. Like my son is a lawyer. If I got some legal thing, guess who handles it? He does. I hate paperwork. I don't read it either. I don't read the fine print. You got to have somebody who understands what's going on with that paperwork. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.